To over 17 Fortune 500 companies and 12 corporate companies that deal with management development and training, and they all want training from the biblical perspective, which is very interesting. Why? Because the system of the world is not working anymore. That's why this comes to so important. So we're going to talk about this very important issue of building. And I wanted to show this picture, because this picture is a sign of pillars that hold up everything. We're going to be focusing on leadership built to last. When the storms and the pressures and everything have hit you, are you still standing? I don't think we've had more tragic falls in leadership than in the past 2 decades. We had Martha Stewart walking around with a brace on her leg from prison. One of the most successful businesswomen in the world went to jail for compromising standards. And of course, we had big companies like Enron, where the executives have been put in prison because they stole money. These were already millionaires. Why are they going to steal money? Well, corruption in the mind, which is corruption in the activities. And these are the people who lead us economically. Then we've had, of course, Catholic priests who have been guilty of abusing little boys and girls. These are the people supposed to be protecting children. But our leaders have fallen. Now Catholic priests are being tried, some put in prison, some being sued, having to pay fines in the millions. What kind of leaders are we following? And then we got government leaders who are being put on trial for their own political disasters. Some of them being put on trial because they stole from their own treasury. Others put on trial because they abuse the humans they're supposed to protect by killing people. I mean, what kind of world are we looking at? So in every arena, economics, religion, and politics, our leaders are failing. Matter of fact, many churches in this very city are suffering from leaders who are guilty of compromise, infidelity, corruption, not only financially but morally. Do you even know some of them? What a tragedy. Who do you follow when this thing is all over? When the pressure hits people, they just kind of fold up under the pressure. We need leaders who are stable. That's why this theme is so important. Now, I have been doing what I'm doing right now for 32 years. I started to help train people and teach people when I was 15 years old. I started very young. Matter of fact, by the time I was 17 years old in my country, my name was a household name. Our organization started from there. At 17 years old, we had become well known all over the country. Matter of fact, my prime minister invited me to meet him when I was 18 years old because he became nervous. He became nervous because, you know, in those kind of political environments, anyone who could draw a crowd larger than 1,000 people becomes very interested by the politicians. And so I was bringing together 5,000 teenagers when I was 17 years old. And I was teaching them about the principles that I learned that helped me from the Bible. And the Prime Minister wanted to meet with me, and we had a chat. We became very good friends after that. And in one of our meetings, 2 weeks later, he gave his life to Jesus in a teenager's meeting. So you never know how God can use you. Now, I've been doing that since then, and I'm still doing it now. I've been married to one woman for 26 years. She took my virginity away. I'm a faithful man. I'm saying this to you because, you see, a lot of people see leaders come and they like novas. You know, novas are a star that burns bright and then it dies. Some people are that way. They appear, they do a great work, and then they fall. We need people who are steady, consistent. They can go through a hurricane and come out still strong. Go through a tragedy, come out still strong. People abandon them, they're still working by themselves. See, we need leadership that is built to last. Now, what I want to focus on is how do you develop strong, stable leadership? That's an important question. Matter of fact, here's what I want to deal with tonight. I want to deal with understanding the principle of construction and development. We're talking about building people, building your leadership character. We're going to be focusing on building on sure foundations.